This video is very unscripted and has very bad audio quality. Please turn on closed caption in YouTube. Thank you. Let's move on to the slides. Hello. Welcome back. So this is my presentation about recording dance dash video using VNC Live with camera movements. Software I use. So I use Live, OBS, Virtual Motion Capture, VMC Protocol Mixer, the FunView, and Blendshift Interceptor. Right? You can find these links in the description. So my setup for VMC, Live, and OBS is different from most of the other people, mainly because I do not like how RingDS Chroma Key makes the color look weird. Alright, so this is my way. And if you do not want to set up this way, you can actually skip to the VMC Blendshift Interceptor part. Alright, this is where you can set up the camera movements and maybe some animations. But animations is not in this video. You can find it out yourself through the GitHub link. So first thing you need to do is open up VMC and then press the settings button, setting up VMC. It's very simple. All you need to do is go settings, wait, set the resolution, install VMK, enable VMK, then from the export this file. This file is important, alright? Remember to put this somewhere you can find, right? That's your desktop, alright? Next, and now you guys open up Lip. You guys select Mixed Reality Capture. Wait. Okay, the Mixed Reality Capture is like camera. And then, Mixed Reality Plus. In this page, we're going to reduce the Lip for iOS. The main reason behind this is because it doesn't show anything. We just want to be blank or empty. Alright. Then enable calibration. Okay. So in the calibration page, remember to import the file that we export from VNC. So remember VNC we exported. So and then we have to select our tracker. The tracker 50 from VMK. And just press save. Then we are done here. Now we open up VMC Protocol Mixer. Right? So we just follow whatever we have here. So first thing you do is you're gonna set up not the file, the VR info, the avatar. And then you set the input quantity to 1 because we only have 1. And the receive port, just follow what I have here, 39539. Okay. Then we gonna select everything except for VNC cam, corner, and key and MIDI. Everything here except for this. Okay? Now, well, in VNC Protocol Mixer, close the menu and just press escape on your keyboard. And then, if you need the menu again, just press space to show it again. What? Up next, OBS. So, most of you already probably know how to set this up, but here we go. So, we're gonna add a game capture. Specify specific window. Alright. And then in here we could add 3 sources. The first one, you have to select list. The next one, select virtual motion capture. Remember, allow transparency. Same goes for virtual motion capture mixer, which is here. And allow transparency. So, this is how my screen look like, alright? So now we have to arrange the source. Always have a relief at the bottom. VMC in the middle. And VNC protocol mixer on top. Often it just resize everything to your liking. So I just resize it like this, you know, you can just drag. You're done resizing. At the end, you'll get this. It should look exactly like this. Okay? So you have VMC Proton Mixer, VMC and this when they advertise. So about maybe for me it's on the left hand side and my main advertise. Yeah. Alright? So moving on. Camera controls. Alright? If you have been following our guide earlier on, down those are optional if you have set up another way. Alright? Let's continue. Start first. Before we start, we need to change something in our VMC protocol. Okay, in the VMC protocol, we should add one. And then we select everything here on site. Alright? And the port, keep it at 39540. That's very important. It needs to be that way. Okay. Go on next. Next, where you enter this page. Alright, I have the link on the description. Just download from the release here. Over here. And yeah. Some of this zip file. Then extract the zip file. Okay. And after you extract the zip file, you have this config JSON. This is where everything is. Alright. So, let's match the numbers. Open up your VMC settings. Then you should see the receiving port. It should be same as performance port. And this part should be exactly same as this part. Alright, let's go next. Okay, so open up this file and we gotta remove everything from blend chips except for the last dock, or whatever you call it. Okay. So it shouldn't look like this at the end. It's only one left. Right? Okay. So, a bit of explanation here. So all we need to do, remember, is actually to set the norm for this part. Name of the movement screen. So we're going to keep it as sample movement screen. Okay. And for these three values, we can leave it exactly like it. And the quad trigger conditions. This is where we can set the buttons. Okay. So this is the controller's right position thumbstick. So if we move the button or the trigger to the right, okay, and this button, right? But for this trigger position thumbstick, I have listed in the description. You can check the description for more information on what to put here for other buttons. Alright, so just make sure that the name is the same. Example buffer script. Example buffer script. Right? This is very similar to Camera Plus. The buffer script in Camera Plus is going to be very, very similar. If you've done anything remotely close to the scripts in Camera Plus, it should be very similar to you. Right, let's move into the movement part. Alright, so this is something that's different than Beat Saber camera movement script. Alright, there is this. This is the bone of your avatar. In this case, it's fixed, which is here. And if you use chest, it'll be chest. You can even use upper arms or lower arms. I have a full list of things you can use in the description. Alright, and this will only work if you have turned to hit, turn on this thing here, chapter 2. Okay? Check. So start position, it's quite self-explanatory. Start position, Start rotation would only work if you have this tangible fellowship. Sure. Then there is a pick offset. This is basically from which you want the camera look on your position, if you understand what I mean. So this is the end position and this end rotation. It's basically the final position or rotation of your camera. So let's say if you want the camera to move from this region that I'm recording. So if you want to move your camera from here to over here, right? And you can set the time, right? The duration. So it takes 2 seconds for me to move from here to there. So 1, 2, 3, and then I stop. Alright, so that was the start position, and this is the end position. Alright, so a bit of explanation on what is XY and Z, how the coordinates work. So it's, if it's positive X, no negative, then positive X means I am moving right side. Okay, and it's negative, it's going to be left side. Then if it's Z, it means that it's way up or down. So positive is of course up, and negative is down. Let's look at my diagram, you understand? Alright. FOV, or field of view. So this option, you need to be seen. If it's different, for some reason, your legs will not align, and it looks very weird in the air. Okay, that's true, my point error, as far as I know, you must have them to be seen. But if you try it, and if it works differently, just let me know, alright? Right, so what's next? So once you're done with the first part as the motion, the first section of a motion, if you only have one, you just only have one, and you do not need the rest. Remember to remove the from here. Right? So, what happens here is, right after the script ends, if you use my previous example, I was here, and I move over the menu. It ended. Okay? Then, the delay will happen. So, if there's a trigger delay, means it will run as soon as possible. Run this part as soon as possible. And there's 1 second delay. You wait 1 second before it moves. Alright. So, in this example, it's going to move. X is 2. So, like I say, X is that side. 2. And then 1.71, which is in front. Okay. And negative 2 is around going down. It's going to be like this. And we are done. Okay. I hope my that explanation works and help you a lot. Let's see. And we are done. Right, thank you for listening. And this is a warning gear, because this explanation is based on my experience and what I understand from reading the GitHub. Alright. I did a lot of trial and error and I finally got it working. Okay. And my values are my values, and it may be different from yours. You can try and learn, and if it works, let me know. If you do not understand anything, just write in the comments. I will try my best to find out, and I will tell you what to do. Alright? Thank you. Goodbye, everybody.